In this closer look, we'll explore mole-to-mole stoichiometry. What is mole-to-mole stoichiometry? Mole-to-mole stoichiometry is when there is a balanced equation and the objective is to convert from moles of one substance in a chemical reaction to moles of a different substance in that reaction. Here's an example of a stoichiometry problem that involves mole-to-mole conversions. Hydrogen and oxygen gas can be generated through the electrolysis of water. The balanced chemical equation is 2 moles of water decomposed to form 2 moles of hydrogen gas and 1 mole of oxygen gas. How many moles of oxygen can be produced from the decomposition of 15 moles of water? To start the problem, take what's given and put it in the upper left-hand corner of the conversion chart. In this one, there are 15 moles of water given as the starting point. The question asks how many moles of oxygen can be produced from the decomposition of those 15 moles of water. So bring the units down, in this case the moles of water, and now use the mole ratio from the balanced equation to convert from moles of water to moles of oxygen. And notice there's a 2 in front of the water, and there's an understood 1 in front of the oxygen. So that means that you put a 2 in front of the water and a 1 in front of the oxygen. Now cancel the units of moles of water, and the converting part of the problem is finished. Now all that's left to do is to multiply 15 times 1 divided by 2, and notice the units are moles of oxygen, which is what the question asked for. And so the answer will be 7.5 moles of oxygen. There will be 7.5 moles of oxygen produced from the decomposition of 15 moles of water. This next problem involves the reaction of sodium metal and chlorine gas to form sodium chloride. And the question asks, how many moles of sodium chloride can be produced from 9 moles of chlorine gas with excess sodium? So start this problem like the other one. Take what's given in the problem, which is 9 moles of chlorine gas, and put that in the upper left-hand corner of the conversion chart. Then bring the units down. So put moles of chlorine down here in the denominator of the next box. And you're converting from moles of chlorine to moles of sodium chloride. These numbers can be found from the mole ratios in the balanced equation. There's an understood 1 in front of chlorine, and there's a 2 in front of the sodium chloride. So put those numbers into the conversion chart here. And notice the units of moles of chlorine cancel, and you're left with moles of sodium chloride, which is what the problem asked for. So to finish solving this question, multiply 9 times 2 divided by 1, which is just 18, and you find that 18 moles of sodium chloride can be formed from the reaction of 9 moles of chlorine gas with excess sodium. Here's one for you to try. This question is also based on the reaction that forms sodium chloride from sodium metal and chlorine gas. It asks, how many moles of sodium chloride can be produced from 4.13 moles of sodium in excess chlorine? Go ahead and pause the video and try to work it on your own, and then press play to check your answer. Hopefully your setup looks similar to this one. We took 4.13 moles of sodium, which was given to us in the problem, and you should have put that in the upper left-hand corner of the conversion chart, brought the units of moles of sodium down, and converted from moles of sodium to moles of sodium chloride. You found from the balanced equation a coefficient of 2 in front of sodium, so you put a 2 here, and a 2 is the coefficient in front of sodium chloride, so you put a 2 here. Notice the units of moles of sodium cancel out, and so you are left with moles of sodium chloride. To solve the problem, you multiply 4.13 times 2 divided by 2, and find that 4.13 moles of sodium chloride can be produced if 4.13 moles of sodium react in excess chlorine. That's a closer look at mole-to-mole stoichiometry. For more chemistry matters, go to our homepage, where the entire series is available to you.